rain crushing and bubble bursting, you. Come on, Hosea. Let's go fishing.
Come on, then. Come on, girl.
Why don't we just fish here? There's a whole lake of them.
Because I need to get out for a bit.
Let's go, Arthur.
Now, I was saying something. Oh, yeah. Because I need to get out for a bit. Me and the old guard. Before any of them back there, oh, there was us.
The curious couple and their unruly son.
It feels good here. You did well finding that spot, Arthur.
More Charles than me.
It's like I can breathe again, thick and soupy as this air is. Might even do your whistling pipes some good, Hosea.
I was once in this country with Bessie. Ah, feels like a lifetime ago.
It was a lifetime ago. But what a life we have lived, how well we have fought, especially both of you.
I hope so.
But now, when things are desperate, we have to stick with the plan. Make enough money, then find somewhere where nobody will find us. But we don't have to hide.
Like where?
I got some ideas hatching, but I need you with me, not against me. Both of you.
Of course.
Still, we do need money. So keep a low profile, especially in the local town. After Valentine, I want everyone on best behavior here. No trouble. But start turning over the soil and the rocks. See what turns up.
Dutch, we have got to be discreet.
Imagine what a slew of rich simpletons there must be down here. Oh, this is perfect for you, Hosea. You'll be able to play them like a fiddle.
Nothing would give me greater pleasure, but...
No buts! Not today. We fish and we enjoy the day. Looks like law up ahead. Play it cool.
Hold.
Gentlemen.
Well, look what the cat drug in.
I seem to have gotten myself in a spot of bother.
Quiet back there.
Well, well, look who it is.
This out.
How are you, boys?
Fine.
This is quite some country you have here.
We like it well enough.
Cody McIntosh, at your service.
Lee Gray. This is my deputy, Archibald McGregor.
It is good to meet you.
You a Scot?
Partly. The best part.
Of course.
Now, tell me, sir, what did the silly, fancy fop back there do? Nothing too terrible, I trust.
He was accused of running a gold mine and investment scam.
Oh, no, 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 no. I'm sure he wasn't. He is a magician. I know him. He's a fool. But he is not a bad fellow. Now, can we just...
I wouldn't do that if I were you!
Shit! The Anderson boys! I can't have more scandal!
Well, allow us to help, my friend. Arthur!
Chase wanted man.
And take Archibald with you.
Just what I signed up for. Come on, big guy!
Perhaps we can discuss the foolish magician.
Let's go after that train!
Keep your guns holstered. We need them Anderson boys alive.
Come on, hurry!
All right.
Come on, we're losing them.
Will you relax? We're not losing them.
Faster, come on. What's your name, sir?
Arthur Callahan.
Faster, Mr. Callahan, please. My neck is on the line here.
I get it. I'm doing my best.
Damn it.
So what are these fellas wanted for? Looks like the son of a bitch is gonna make it. You sure I can't just shoot him?
No! Did I not say that?
You said plenty.
Look at you two fellas all curled up! You and all...
Idiot! Now get after the others, come on! The train is slowing down to go through the station. Now's our chance. Get to the side of the train. See the flat carriage? Head for that. Get us as close as you can. You think you can jump on there?
Me? Why me?
Because you ride like my grandmother. Now he's throwing bottles. The lowest.
Yes, he gonna wait to love us.
Bring him out here.
Deputy?
Sounded like quite a commotion. Is that him?
I sincerely hope so.
Old Anders Anderson.
So what now?
Take him in. Come on. A fine job. Well done. And a pat on the back for me for stopping the train.
You all right,
there girl? You go. You are a natural. All right, let's take him in. Follow me.
What about the others?
Oh, we'll round them up. Anders back there is the brains of the operation, and that's really saying something.
You're the boss.
That was mighty impressive, sir, I have to admit. I'd hazard a guess you've served the law yourself at some point.
Well, I wouldn't exactly say that.
Are you familiar with the area here?
No, not really.
On your right here, these tobacco fields? This is part of Calliga Hall, big estate belonging to the Gray family.
Looks bone dry.
Yes, we are in dire need of some rain round here, let me tell you. The Grays have lived in Calliga Hall for generations. Fine people. My family's been working for them for years. Sheriff Gray's the one I know best, of course, but they own half the businesses in town.
Which town?
Rhodes, sir. You don't know it? Where we're headed right now. Ain't what it was before the war, but it has its charms. I'm sure you already know of the Braithwaites.
Like I said, just got down here.
Another big family in these parts. They have an estate west of here. Awful people, truly awful. They've been fighting with the Grays for as long as I can remember.
Sounds like quite the place you got here.
We're gonna bear left here.
Here we are. Welcome to Rhodes. Up there on your left is the Rhodes Parlor House. Very reputable saloon owned by the Gray family. We also have a general store, gunsmith, post office, train station, of course.
What more do you need?
Oh, good. They're back. And that's your friend, right?
Yep.
Okay, we're gonna stop just ahead on the right, outside the sheriff's office. Can you grab Anders off your horse and carry him in for me? Bring him in so we can show Sheriff Gray.
Hey, fellas.
Carry him over, then.
Mr. Gray! We got him.
Very good.
I told you Arthur would deliver. Man has a passion for justice.
That's wonderful.
So, about my friend here?
Your idiot friend is free to go. But no more trouble from you, partner.
I promise you, this was all just a big misunderstanding. However, I want to thank you from the bottom of my heart.
I'll pretend to appreciate that. Mr. McIntosh, it has been a real pleasure. The mostly good citizens of Rhodes, we welcome you.
Well, we're just honored to be here.
And make your friend behave. We got enough trouble from some of the residents, old-timers who've gone sadly to seed and lost their dignity.
How terrible. Come along now. I will keep this fellow on the straight and narrow.
Well, come back and see us sometime soon. Excuse me, gentlemen. Beau, these better be ugly rumors. Is it true you were seen talking to that wretched Penelope Braithwaite?
I can't thank you enough.
Where have you been?
Around.
And where are you staying?
I'm renting a caravan on the edge of town behind the church. It's horrible, but no one comes looking. The whole town is trapped in this interminable feud between the two families. His lot, Gray's, and Braithwaite's.
Interesting.
Two old plantation houses and them falling out of rebel gold and marrying cousins or not marrying...
Arthur, Jose, you start poking around. See what you can find out about that.
I have missed you, boys. I've heard about bounty.
Well, there's been a price on my head for 13 years. It'll take a month to find us down here, and it seems like we can have a little sport.
Well, they're good bounties.
Where you hear this?
Some fellas I met at a camp near the state line said there was talk of it in bars in the north and west for 500 miles. There was talk of super agents of some sort.
Super agents? I'd love to meet one. It's just talk.
I'm sure it is, but I could not tell you.
Stay out of trouble.
Thank you, gentlemen.
Okay, so these two plantation families. Arthur, you start sniffing around the Gray's place, see what the story is there.
Yeah, I passed by it earlier with our friend, Archibald.
Good. Hosea, you see what you can find out about these Braithwaites.
All right. Thank you, Arthur.
Quite a fishing trip.
There's still time. I'm up for it.
How about you, Arthur? Or have you had enough of the chase for one day?
Sure, why not?
Great. Hosea, why don't you lead us to that spot you were talking about? Kind of like this place.
Okay. Let's see if we can avoid any more excitement.
Work's dried up like an old dead frog. There's a job in 5 miles in here I don't know about.
Don't expect anything else from this shithole.
These things.
Bloodbath and Valentine. Read all
Mudtown
about it.
Mudtown claimed another. Some fool fell off his horse.
All right, gentlemen. Follow me.
So how far is this creek?
It's a bit of a ride still. And it's not a creek. It's the same lake we camped on, just a different pipe. It'll be worth it. I saw some big drum and sturgeon there. Should be rock bass, bluegills, perch, pickerel, too. It's a good spot.
We'll see if you're as good at catching fish as you are at catching criminals, Arthur.
Trelawney owes me for that.
Trelawney owes everyone for something. But his information is good.
Plus, we are now ingratiated with the local law. I'd say it was a worthwhile diversion all around.
Ha! Trelawney's like a bad penny.
I'm not sure how good a magician he is, but he's certainly good at disappearing when he feels like it.
Where does he go?
Everywhere and nowhere, it seems. We wouldn't have got Sean back if he hadn't been weaseling around down that way, though.
Hey, Dutch, remember that time you found him in the outhouse?
Oh, yeah. We hadn't seen him in weeks. We stopped in some dead-end town in the middle of nowhere. Don't even remember the name.
You and Bill were off doing something, Arthur.
So, we pick up some supplies. I go to relieve myself. Open the door, and there's Trelawney, sitting there, newspaper in hand. Mr. Vanderlyn, I say, what the hell are you doing here? And he said, I could ask you the same thing. Now, if you wouldn't mind giving me a little privacy, I ate a rotten oyster.
Hey, maybe there are actually 100 Trelawneys.
What a terrible thought. This is the spot. Down to the left there.
You done good, girl.
Cold?
I saw some boats around last time. Be good to get to deeper water. Yes, over there on the shore. I'm sure nobody would mind if we borrowed one of these. Come on. All right. This looks like a fine vessel.
Okay. Come on, Arthur. Let's get her in the water. Oh,
oh. I got a good feeling about fishing here. It's supposed to be some incredible sturgeon.
Oh. Okay, here we go. Let me row. You boys are too old for real labor no more.
You're too dumb for anything else.
You're still too quick for me, old man.
I enjoy picking on children.
Now take us to the deeper water and pray for good luck and stupid fish.
What about stupid luck and good fish?
That'll do, too.
Keep going. I think here's good.
All right. Good luck, gentlemen.
Should really come here at dawn or dusk. That's when you catch the best fish. We should use a lake lure. That'll give us a much better chance of hooking something big like a sturgeon.
What's wrong with a good old worm?
Oh, worms are good for tiddlers like bluegill and rock bass, but you'd have to be real lucky to catch a sturgeon with one.
Lures it is, then. You heard the expert, Archer. Let's bait up.
Keep the lure moving slowly on the water so it looks like a little fish just asking to be eaten. Mm-hmm. looks like you got a bite, Arthur.
Nice, you hooked him. I think that's a bite. There he is.
They can grow a lot bigger than that. Fella told me he once saw a monster lake sturgeon near the mouth of the river, just southwest of Saint Denis. 50-pounder, he reckoned.
I would like to see that. Hey, Hosea. That time we sent Arthur out fishing, he came back with 3 beautiful bass.
Not this again.
I don't think I do.
Oh, yeah. You do. He was maybe 20. 21, walked in all full of himself. We had a big feast, toasted him all night.
This was 15 years ago.
Oh, I remember now.
Then, the next week, Arthur and I are at the market, and Fishmonger calls out, "So how did you enjoy those bass?"
Look, you can fish, or you can go drinking all day, rob someone, and buy some fish.
Good job, Arthur. I used to go fishing with this feller back in the day. Wesley, his name was. Real miserable bastard, but he loved to fish. We'd go out all the time. But one day, we were river fishing when we see a funeral procession going over the bridge, and out of the blue, Wesley stands up, takes off his hat, bows his head. Then he sits down, picks his rod back up, and carries on. Doesn't say a word. So I'm a little surprised and say, "Wesley, that was nice of you." And he replies, "Well, felt I had to. After all, I was married to her for 30 years.
Oh, there he is.
Oh, dear God. I might swim to shore.
Now reel him in, Arthur. Well done. Remember those big salmon I caught in Montana last year? We had a banquet planned that night until Copper went and scoffed a lot.
You never had control of that dog.
Yeah, it's the spirit, though. Never lost a puppy in him, not to the end.
You know, I remember us saying how Blackwater was the furthest east we'd ever been. As a group, I mean.
Feels like the more we try to head west, the further east we end up.
We had all those safe spots picked out to lie low in New Austin after the ferry job.
I liked it there. Still open and wild the way it should be. Somehow the desert makes you feel closer to the sky.
No point us trying to get back that way anytime soon. Pinkertons have patrols out all over tall trees and great plains. We saw when we went back to Sean.
Well, look at us now, huh? It could be worse. Plans change. That's just how life goes. You're getting the hang of this. Did I ever tell you my mother's buried in Blackwater?
Really? She is?
Apparently so. I only found out from an uncle of mine years later. Last I knew, she was still outside Philadelphia. I left home at 15 and didn't see her again. She and I didn't always see eye to eye. I wasn't always a very obedient child.
I can only imagine.
Still, I loved her in my own way. And she me in hers. Somehow, even from the grave, she managed to have the last laugh.
Something's nibbling. There we go. Nicely done, Arthur. That one gets to fight another day, huh?
Arthur's got a bike. There you go. That's a nice one. Make sure you don't forget about that and let it rot in the bag.
Hey, I reckon we call it a day, fellas.
Already?
You ain't been chasing down outlaws.
All right. Think we got a decent haul here. Pearson will be happy. Should we head back?
We could keep the boat, not too far back to camp from here.
Good idea. Could be useful.
What about the horses?
Well, they'll find their way back.
Just follow the shore south, Arthur.
That was fun.
Uh-huh.
Thank you, boys. Now, Hosea.
Yes?
How about a song?
Okay. All right, I got one for you. I asked that gal to give me something.
I asked that gal to give me some. She says, wait till the taters is done. I couldn't wait till the taters was done. I couldn't wait till the taters was done. Threw her on the floor and knocked off some. I wish to God I'd passed her by. I wish to God I'd passed her by. Taters got burnt and so did I.
That was pretty good. But you know, what song we should be singing?
What?
Well, look at us. Three mariners.
Ah, of course.
Well, we be three poor mariners newly come from the seas. We spend our lives in jeopardy while others live at ease. Shall we? Dancers round, 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 shall we go dancers round, round, round? Hey, that is a bully boy, come pledge me on his round, 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 round. We care not for martial men that do our states disdain, but we care for the merchantmen that do our states maintain. To them we dance this round, round, round. To them we dance this round, round, round. And he that is a bully boy, come pledge me on this ground, the ground, the ground, the ground, the ground, the ground, the ground.
Oh, bravo! Bravo! Well, you know, we should not let the folks back in camp think that we had too much fun.
Indeed not.
All right. I think we are gonna be okay. I know. I always know whenever I got you two by my side, things are gonna be just fine. This place will be good for us. For now, anyway.
I hope so.
Well, I am going to take in the view.
I'll give these fish to Pearson.